There are 6 non-price determinants that we will be learning, which influences the level of supply. Firstly, variations of weather conditions can cause different levels of production. For instance, a country experiencing a drought faces a destruction of crop fields, which will decrease the level of supply of harvests. Secondly, the level of technology directly influences the productivity and level of output. For example, an improvement in technology, such as increased use of machinery, increases the level of output with the same amount of resources used as inputs. As a result, the average cost of production is being reduced, and producers face a higher expected profit. Profit-maximizing firms then increase the level of supply. Next, the changes in prices of related goods, such as goods in joint supply or in competitive supply, have varying effects on the level of supply. For instance, the increase in the price of leather increases its quantity supplied. Since leather and beef are in joint supply, there is also an increase in supply of beef. However, for goods in competitive supply, such as biofuel and food crops, a rise in price of biofuel may increase its supply, but decrease the supply of food crops. Following on, an increase in input prices, such as firms facing an increase in cost production, lowers their expected profits, and hence lowering the supply. Next on the list is the implementation of government policies, such as taxes or subsidies. On one hand, if the government raises taxes or newly implements taxation, this increases the cost of production for firms, which lowers their expected profits and supply. On the other hand, if subsidies are implemented, this lowers the cost of production. And the reverse holds true. Last but not least, the number of sellers in an industry influences the level of supply available. A large number of sellers would increase the total supply. In conclusion, these 6 factors determine the level of supply.